Hey guys, welcome back to some Mechwarrior, and today we're doing something a bit, well, we're doing Solaris, but I was informed that I do not have to do all the fucking Solaris missions. That would probably explain a lot. I had no idea I didn't have to do them all, because I don't think I've ever finished Solaris. Apparently I think I only have to do one in each category, so that's what we're gonna do, to keep this interesting. Apparently, yes, you can go all through them, and I think the idea is, if you want to get a lot more money, if you're short on the money, then that's, I think, what you're supposed to do. It's just an option, but the thing is, they didn't really, like, as I said, it's not really explained that it's an option at all, so, I don't know, let's do some victory, let's do some, this is factory, so this is gonna be a hot map, so, once again, for Steiner, and we're gonna go on our Jenner, and the Jenner, I only chose the Jenner because it's a mech that's near and dear to my heart. I'm actually having difficulty choosing mechs now because I'm just like, some of them are incredibly boring and I don't really want to play them. But I'm trying to pick ones that are interesting and that are near and dear to my heart kind of thing. So the Jenner is one of them. So I put on three C-Strike 6 missiles and then a bunch of small clan ER lasers, small lasers as well. So it's mostly like a kind of like a weird missile boat thing. So let's get started.
In Montenegro, the sun is setting behind Merrick Tower. People are still crowding the streets, waiting to get into one of Solaris's most popular arenas. You know what that means? That's right, Solaris fans! It's factory time! This is Duncan Fisher, and we have an exciting, fast-paced, lightweight Solaris match for you tonight. Many of the legends of Solaris got their start in the lightweight circuit, so perhaps we'll see some future stars tonight. So stay tuned for some intense action in the junk heap. It's Solaris time!
Jenner's so adorable, holy shit.
Active radar engaged. Enemy detected.
Oh fuck, this guy's fast. I need to get a lock on this guy. I don't think I need to get a lock. I just forgot these are C-Strikes.
There goes our favorite of the game. Well, this is live Solaris.
Holy shit.
It's unpredictable and fast, and you can never tell who's gonna come out on top.
This guy's getting wrecked by me. I forgot that C-Strikes don't need a lock in this game. Dude, C-Strikes are amazing, holy shit.
Target destroyed.
Wow, maybe I don't need that many because I think I'm going to run out of ammo.
It's a real slugfest down there. Makes me want to mount up and join them. Nope. Looks like they'll hold me back. Next time, maybe.
Hey, check out my fucking, the thing in the bottom right. It looks like I only have like one arm or one torso thing at the top. Messed up.
Enemy detected.
Oh, look at this guy. It's Terrence.
That shot had his name on it.
So the thing about lights is there's like no good ballistics for it. You either have machine guns or you have machine guns for ballistics, you know. Actually kind of sucks.
Target destroyed.
Like, I actually want to use a little bit more ballistics.
Warning.
But
heat exceeding recommended level.
Light mech pilots over the years share one common complaint. It all boils down to weapon envy. At this level of competition, there are a slew of weapons that just won't fit on a chassis. There's just something satisfying about having a big gun or PPC in your arsenal. Spectre's tearing through him today. That's his second kill of the game.
Okay, I can't make it over this wall. I have weapon envy. I wish I had fucking gosses or some shit. This guy's so fucking dead. Look at this guy. Where do you think you're going? Oh, apparently right there.
From Merc Jock to Solaris Jock, this Spectre is showing everyone how to take care of business. Three kills on the board, and maybe some more to come.
Oh, there's only one left, so.
Warning. Heat exceeding recommended level.
The Merkman wins.
Jenner's fun.
Fast and furious. That's the way the light mech competitions go. Our winner tonight is Spectre, a rookie Solaris pilot to watch. He's earned his victory lap. Live from the factory, this is Duncan Fisher signing off. See you next match, Solaris fans.
That's a fun mech though. Let's just go right on to the last one there. Orbital view, Colosseum light, Jenner, in the Steiner.
It's game day over in Silesia, Solaris fans. This is Duncan Fisher announcing from a completely packed Colosseum. Steiner's Colosseum is the only open-class arena where spectators can watch the game live, and it looks like the fans are really taking advantage of that today. The light mech pilots are getting onto the field, and it looks like we're going to have a heck of a game for you today.
Look at this shit. There's like no cover.
It's Solaris time.
Oh, this guy's a raven. Who the fuck puts a PPC on a mech?
Listen, both of us are a notch above all the others. Call it a truce till we take them all out.
Oh, look, it's the guy I was just shooting. What the fuck is this beeping?
Active radar engaged. Enemy detected.
Something's beeping at me. And it's the game. Yeah, it's literally the game is beeping at me. The fuck?
One of these days, I'm gonna see if I can sneak back into the arena for another game. Yeah, it's been 10 years, but I still have what it takes. At least that's what every former Solaris jock tells themselves. I guess I'll just stay in the booth. For today, at least.
I still have no idea
what's going on. Fans like their games fast and furious. I like them more like this. People are fighting smart and trying to minimize their exposure. A good pilot knows just how to turn to spread out the damage. It makes for a longer fight, which sometimes you win, sometimes you don't. That guy is out of here.
I don't like how he basically interrupts himself to talk about a kill.
And carefully lined up the shot. A lot of times, that's the way you gotta play it. He's one step closer to victory.
Because, like, he's in the middle of saying something, and then he interrupts himself and never finishes the thought. Like, there, he was just about to say something. I killed someone. Solaris sucks. That's
not
okay.
All pilots do well in the field, then come to Solaris and do well for themselves. But this Spectre is really showing what transition is all about. Three folks go home losers just because they underestimated this guy.
Holy shit! This guy has LRMs? That's all he has! Look at this guy!
Warning.
That's all he had.
Just one man left. Bam! That's it for today. The winner is Spectre, the fancy Merc hotshot turned Solaris jock. He's chalked up another victory on the sands of the Colosseum. I just bet we'll be seeing more of him. Well, take care, Solaris fans. This is Duncan Fisher signing off.
That's fucking ridiculous. Anyways, what do we have left now? Alright, we're up to medium. I don't have anything good for that. But I have... I want to fuck around with the Bushwhacker, so give me a sec. Alright, so I did something with the Bushwhacker LBX. I actually gave it a rotary cannon. I wanted to try this. I have no idea. I've never used this before in a Mechwarrior game, so let's give that a try. I don't know if I should call it LBX, but I think I will, just because fun. So let's do that. And if that one sucks, I'll just use a crab laser PPC. That's fine.
The factory is abuzz tonight. That's right, it is factory time. This is Duncan Fisher reporting live from downtown Montenegro. And the talk tonight is about Peter Dexter. He has come out of retirement and is anxious to get another chance at the Solaris Championship. His last light game was a brutal display of skill, and this old dog has learned some new tricks. There is a sold-out crowd here tonight. You know what that means.
Alright, so this is what I mean about it being hot. So if I stand on this, I think it raises my heat level. Yeah, there you go. Look at that. It goes up. So we want to be careful there. So I'm going to go kick Peter Dexter's ass here. He doesn't even know what's coming. Bitches don't know about my clan rotary cannon with 60 shots on it.
Peter Dexter is down there tonight. Back in his prime, it would have been a no-brainer who was going to win this one. But he's been in retirement for 5 years. And it's been 8 years since he did his career best and placed 37th in the charts. He's back and nailed 3 victories in a row in the light circuit. Now he's primed to show the medium pilots what an old veteran can do. He ain't getting any younger, but he has a ton of talent and experience. I fought Peter back in the day, and he is one pilot who cannot be ignored. I think we will be seeing a lot more of him this season.
This motherfucker has...
Look at all that ordnance fly. Man, I love a good fight. My favorite weapon was the AC-5. It has a nice recycle, and you can keep someone rocking if you get your timing right. I hear somebody... He's out of here!
Alright, that guy's dead. Dude, that guy had fucking... This guy, Peter Dexter, has fucking four client LRMs. That's all he has. So literally, if he doesn't get a lock on me, or if I'm like really close to him, he's gonna like do no damage almost. This fucking piece of shit. Hello. Peter fucking Dexter. Apparently he does a lot of damage at close range anyways.
I just got this off the wire, folks, and it's official. Bobby Killer Fields has been fined and disqualified for the season. Ouch! And there goes Peter Dexter. A real shame, too. I thought he'd go the distance today. I really did. And from the audience reaction, I think they were expecting it, too. But there are plenty of games left in the season, and I'd be surprised if we don't see some more death and destruction, and now we have our final three. It's been a pretty fast match so far, and it doesn't show any signs of slowing.
Alright, well, the clan rotary cannon sucks balls. I mean, I don't know if I'm just not using it right or whatever, but I don't know, I'd rather have fucking... For the amount of weight that this thing, like, requires, it's kind of just garbage. I don't really understand what the appeal of it. Like, oh, okay, wait, it fires much faster than that, and it jams. Okay, that's why. Weapon jammed. It takes forever. Holy shit. Can it, like, not jam? Alright, here we go.
It looks like Spectre wants to take first today. He's just nailed his second pilot for the match.
Okay, maybe that's not as bad, but it jams like a motherfucker. What's this guy got? This guy has no weapons left. This guy's he's lost. Can our weapon not jam? Like, I don't really like jam. Okay, so that's why I didn't feel like it was doing a lot of damage. I was supposed to fucking spam it until it fucking jams like that. That's retarded though, but still. I can see that being, like, a good weapon.
Spectre does it again! Things are really picking up now. The season may have started slow, but now it's picking up steam. Today, we have a Merc rookie doing the victory lap. His name is Spectre, and this season he has really been turning some heads. He fought his way through the light class, and seems to be holding his own in the mediums as well. Live from the factory, it's Duncan Fisher signing off.
Alright, I'm getting tired of these LRM boats I keep seeing in these things, but anyways, let's go to Orbital View, Coliseum Medium, and let's bring out the good old Crab Laser PPC. Except it doesn't look like it has anything equipped on it. That's because I don't have one of the fucking things it's supposed to have. Because it probably got blown off at some point, and then, I think during one of the other missions. I want to get into the heavies, like, immediately. Because I like the mediums. Alright, that's pretty much it. Alright, let's go Crab Laser PPC. For our glorious Steiner.
The sun is set behind the Coliseum. The stadium lights are on, and we have a game tonight. This is Duncan Fisher giving you the play-by-play. There are a couple of Steiner up-and-comers in tonight's game, and it has drawn quite a crowd. In the last Coliseum game, there was some real tension in the stands. The Davion and Steiner supporters seemed like they were coming close to blows, but the security is tight, and all signs point to a fabulous game. Solaris time!
Can I just shoot this guy from here? I totally can! Oh, yeah. Hey, well, there goes his fucking torso. I think it's everybody.
Enemy detected.
This shit has range, man. I think
enemy detected.
Yeah, whatever. Enemy detected. Whatever. Thank God I didn't spawn next to any of these fuckers.
One of the combatants tonight is both a Merc and Solaris Junk. His name is Alex Haight. This no-nonsense fighting machine had a sensational rookie year and followed it up by disappearing for mysterious business for two whole seasons. Everyone thought that was the last of him, but he came back and is still doing some serious damage in his fifth season. It's a no-brainer that he'll make it into the big game. It's kind of unusual, but he still fights a couple of medium matches every year. He says he's scoping the field. Alex isn't a man of many words, but he's a clever warrior. I wonder what he sees out there tonight.
He sees a giant PPCs in the face.
Every now and then, I like to step back and appreciate each fighter in a match. True, some pilots will never go that far. But you know what? Just being here, they are some of the best the Inner Sphere has to offer. Sure, being ranked at 100 is discouraging, but that can still make you one of the best pilots anywhere else. The battle looks to be mostly about cover. There have been some bad shots, good defense, and good movement. It makes for a longer game, but it shows off some good piloting. Although some of those guys could use some practice with their gunnery. The medium circuit has definitely picked up. We have a few new faces that are really shaking things up. And that's what it's all about. Terrence Munson has come. Kapow! Well, Alex is slumming it, and he gets nailed. He was scoping out the competition, and looks like he found some. I don't know whether he was just overconfident, or if he just got outplayed, but regardless, I bet he ain't a happy camper. See you next game, Alex.
Alright, this isn't a very good mech. Right. I think I was using this in jungle, where I had a lot less heat issues. This is not exactly the place for energy weapons. I'm almost done with my coolant as well. I don't know what I think about this. I mean, honestly, I hate the crab mech anyways, because it's like a giant fucking walking centaur, so, as you've heard me say several times. So, sucks to be me, I guess. Did I miss this guy? What? Heresy.
Warning, heat exceeding recommended level.
Shit sucks, man. I don't even think dipping my feet in the water I guess it does lower it slightly.
Bam, bam, bam. Spectre makes it look easy. Anything Spectre gets in his crosshairs winds up as junk metal. That's number four.
Alright, let me just go down here into the water. Alright, I think this is the last one. Yeah, this is the last guy. Alright, it's time to mean you, buddy. Well, say goodbye to your fucking left torso there. And
kapow, the rest of you. The Colosseum has seen some intense fighting tonight. Although those medium mechs are fast, they can pack some serious punch. It was quite a slugfest, and rookie Merc Spectre takes the victory today. He smashed through some serious opposition, and he's earned the accolades tonight. Live from the sands, it's Duncan Fisher wishing all of you a good night.
You know, we're just blazing through this shit, so this is actually going pretty good. Also, I should stop swearing so much, because I watched some of my previous episodes, and I'm like, I seem like such an LP memer. I'm just like, fuck this, fuck that. And I'm just enjoying games. Alright. So, we got just the heavies left. And I have a couple of mechs to show you. Well, actually just like three. Or something. Alright. So, I picked... So, the mech that I kind of picked to basically be kind of like... It's not like a very good chassis, but I used to play with it a lot in, actually, you know what? I want to fuck around with this because I just realized that this is, like, not right. Oh, god damn it. I don't want reactive armor. Alright, give me a sec. Alright, whatever, this is what I did with it. Just fucking, it's a meme mech now. Light machine guns in there, I am swearing again. I just didn't want the other reactive armor on. I forgot to change it out. I hate that armor. So I made this monster. It's gonna be crap. And then the other one I made was... Oh yes, this is gonna be probably my actually good one. And let me give it some cool blue armor. two clan gosses and a bunch of medium lasers. This is like the actual good one. And the other one is just like, I used to like going in this. You used to like, well, not used to, but I played it in Mechwarrior Online and that game was actually not crap. And you could put like two gosses on it. It's basically a modified version of the catapult with like ballistic slots. And you could put gosses on it, which is fun, but you can't do that in this game apparently. So instead, this is what I did with it. It looks like crap now. Whatever, who cares? I just want to have fun, man. It brings back memories of a game that used to be okay.
You know what time it is, Solaris fans? Factory time! Duncan Fisher here. It's a fine day in Montenegro, as long as you stay clear of the arena. People are piled in to see the latest match of the heavy season. We have some great mech action in store today. As you know, this heavy season has been one of Steiner domination. They have four heavy pilots who have been destroying all who face them. The events outside of Solaris seem to really be pushing them to go that extra mile on the battlefield. There's a lot of energy in the air, and it looks like we're going to have a great game today. It's time, Solaris fan.
This guy didn't even get hurt by my shit. Fuck that. I'm going this way.
Enemy detected.
Alright, so this chassis is for, so there's no missiles on it, but it's normally for, like, PPCs on the top, that's why you see the big guns.
The competition is pretty fierce tonight, but one of the hopefuls is rookie Spectre. He's a dangerous Merc pilot who's strung together several victories in multiple weight classes. He's versatile, has a good head on his shoulders, and he is by far the favorite tonight. But this is Solaris, so you can never tell who the last man standing will be. Well, he gets to add another notch on his mech for that one. Of course, his mech looks in bad shape, too. It's the nature of the game, and if you take too much damage in the beginning, the odds aren't good you'll last until the end. You have to pace yourself for the whole match.
All right.
Warning, heat exceeding recommended level.
The machine guns here generate like zero heat, so...
Warning, heat exceeding recommended level.
This guy just die. I don't want to actually be right near him, so...
Spectre has nailed another. That's two today.
A mech hat would actually be a good mech to have for this. Oh, look, this guy's so dead. Just die. Please. No!
The heavy season has been kind of one-sided. Steiner pilots have definitely been avoiding each other down there. Hey, that's nothing new. Pilots tend to have their own agendas. Some fancy piloting, good aim, and three kills for Spectre. Now that is one Merc I'd let watch my back any day.
Enemy detected.
Alright, well... whatever, we'll just finish this guy off. I was gonna say, I could talk about Mech 3 a bit. That game is even more buggy than this one. A lot of people have been asking me about like how I get this running.
Spectre has taken out four again.
This is actually a good mech. It was better than I thought. I thought this would be trash. Oh shit! This guy has like no damage. Let's get out of here for a second. Okay. Apparently, I'm being ganged up on. I'm going this way. I'm gonna guess these are two Steiner guys because they fucking don't care about each other.
Radar off. Passive sensors engaged.
Oh, what a bunch of assholes. They're teaming up on me. I may actually lose this one. I think I'm gonna lose this one. Because I don't think I can actually take both of them. They're only going for me. Alright, you know, here's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna go back here. And I'm gonna shut down. Maybe they'll forget about me.
I like a fight that has a break in the middle of it. Some fights are so fast and furious that by the time you realize what's happened, it's all over. I much prefer matches like these, where you can ooh and ah at the skill and savor the victory.
And no, I kind of bounced on the wall. Alright, I'm hoping that they're gonna get distracted and shoot at each other. Because a lot of my stuff is not looking that good. This is gonna be hard now. Like, it's like, this is the problem. Like, two Argus mechs decided to just start railing on me. Alright, looks like they're fighting each other now. Or they're looking for me, because they missed where I went. Since my sensors went on, this guy seems to know where I am now. Yeah, it looks like they're together. What a bunch of fucking assholes. I mean, it makes sense, because sometimes they'll fucking team up against me.
Warning. Damage critical. Weapon destroyed.
Aw, oh, man.
Target destroyed.
Alright, let's see what I got left. I can still do it. It's still doable. It's gonna be difficult though. This guy have.
Alright. Weapon destroyed.
Come on. Just die.
Ah, man.
This is gonna be one fucking damaged mech. Come on, just die. CT, come on, CT, CT. I can't fucking see it. Damn, you just die. Oh my fucking
Spectre, he's amazing. We're about halfway through our season, and yet again, Spectre has come out on top. If you haven't heard of this kid, you should have. It's his first season, but from his performance tonight, you couldn't tell. He slugged his way through some serious talent to take the prize tonight. And I bet we'll see him back in the factory later. It's been a heck of a game. This is Duncan Fisher from the factory.
Probably not taking that mech anymore. But yeah, that's all the time we have for today. Next time, well, I guess we'll finish up Solaris or whatever. So take care. Bye.